Now it is my happy privilege to turn the service over to our pastor, Sister Rose. Please welcome her as she comes.
It's good to be here today. The Lord is good. He continues to bless us and to minister to us. We are grateful for everything that He has done. May I say we're glad for all of our visitors this morning. Glad that you came to church. This is real church. Yes, believe it or not. Yes, I don't know what I would do if it wasn't for the Lord on my side. Today the Lord is good. Isn't He good to you? Yes. We ought to worship Him like that. And He's been good. We think it's all about this because we're glad to see you this morning. We pray that God would reach out and touch your lives and minister to your needs. And I tell you, you will not come to this church with reasons and not having known you've been in the presence of God. So we're glad that you're here today. Now, the Bible service is the first Corinthians, the 13th chapter. Father, we love you today. We appreciate you with all of our hearts. We thank you because you never failed us. You loved us when we didn't love ourselves. We thank you that you reached out to us. Make a difference in our lives. I pray, God, that you bless every person in this building today. I pray, God, that you serve them as only you can. And we'll give you glory and honor in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. God, as I go to bed, I think it's about life, giving somehow, whether it's a month or a month. I just thank you about this extension of in the town. I'm so they know what it's like. Thank you. was a young man on Sunday before, down in the line, and he wanted me to pray for him, and he said, I can hear voices. You didn't talk to her in the news of people that kill people because a voice told me to do it. Something is going to be set all around us. It's a good thing when you can get alone and get in your house by yourself, take the world out, and enjoy some fun. There's so much noise everywhere. Everywhere you look, there's more and more noise, people talking, music playing, and people listening. No wonder we don't hear the voice of God. No wonder we don't even know His voice. Thank you. want you to do it. What do you want me to do?
But when she left, a voice told her,
things to do. Now,
I'm
turn my testament and tell you what a man of God or not. I listened to him. When he told me that he was God, I sat there with the former Washington. I went to this meeting, but he also got kicked at the time. I and nobody has killed the roles to run. Come on, slow move on. What are you thinking? If you're going to make a spiritual thing, you're going to slow and move it on anything. So what's the point here telling me to run? That's why you've been going for 59 years.
And
what was going on. The car is still at the end of my daughter's life until we couldn't find out what was going on. You don't know what's going on. But how do you know that God is going to take her in? So, you don't have to tell us what this is going to take you. because now he comes looking for you. Where you at? You don't even know you're naked at the beginning. But now that sin has come into your life, you understand that you don't want one of these clothes. So God says, I'm not going to wear the clothes. He knew his voice because he changed the need for the rest of his life. And the other side of the answer says, you see it out. I'm here because I'm able to see. You see it out. No one has seen it. He said, so, I have a nation with that. Who told you you were naked? You're supposed to know that. And you know you found out that you're naked and you're looking for things that need to make you some clothes. You wouldn't be in that position if you didn't see me. They're also worth praise to. But if you're on the right side, they're trying to help you to stay on the right side. And if I was going to, they'll tell you about their experiences, or they'll tell you about people that they know did this and did that, and this didn't go very well with you. They're all the same thing. You've got to be listening sometimes. And when we don't, you can't be able to respond. The boy back home, he lives in the same building he lived at, in the closet. He's heard more than one voice. He heard his mama's voice and he heard his son's voice. Now he chose to follow his voice. I never will forget that to this day. And after it comes to me years ago. But that boy laying there on the ground, gasping for breath, dancing, because he just got scared and kicked him out of the grave. You said, the church of Christ has no voice, for the voice of God speaking to my brother. Change the difference. You know, like I know, we raised the same church. What's the point? And when we came in, we took it down to the town. We took it to the church. We was playing the glory of Jesus God and Mr. Chief. And we said, we need to start a time to give you a job. Just like that, girl, I'm not very, huh? You old-fashioned, just like you. That's all I want. And I'm here today, and I'm saying, keep the law. That's it. It's punishing. Never did get that. Don't you think we're all just talking to him? You just remember. Keep it off. And you probably will think of him this morning, while at the end of this message, you would be thinking,
Thank you.
for every man to die, and after that to be judged. Man's bound on accepting he cannot pass. From the time you were born and before, from the time you accepted you were going to die. But you can change it. You can give your life to him. No matter what happens, good or bad.